Jumping knee for the champ. Haida falls back again. Another jump to the right hand. Backs up Haida. Jumping knee.
Back.
Fist of Fury 3. Haida's got to get on the inside. Cannot stay on the outside at the range of Eersel.
You know, Haida told me he wants to control center circle, but it's so hard because of the pressure that Regian Eersel puts on his opponents.
Southpaw stance here for Haida. Good forearm guard against the right round kick. Goes body shot off the cross. Skip up round kick there. Circling away from the power side of Eersel. Good round kick, tucks it under the right arm. Eersel counters off the back leg. Overhand right from the champion. Jab two from Eersel, backs up Haida. There's the first flying knee.
Step back.
Like the stream just come from Eersel. They come right through the guard.
Body shot, outside leg kick.
It's also really hard to hit Eersel because of his guard. He's got this really tight hand position that creates almost a shield around his face. It's very difficult to connect cleanly on Regian Eersel.
Body shot to outside leg kick scores well for Haida. Body shot to uppercut. Looking for the body early on, Mustapha Haida, really establishing that dipping left hand. And it's coming off the rear hand, being the power hand out of southpaw stance. Good right hand lead there from Eersel, rock the head back.
That's the third right hand from Eersel that's landed solidly in this round.
Regian said he spent a lot of time working on his foot placement to fight the southpaw. He wants to step to the outside of Haida's lead leg and fire that right hand right down the middle, and it's landed over and over again.
Usually, most people will set up a right cross with a jab, but Eersel does it so well as a leading punch, given the length of his arms too. Body shots ahead. Again, looking for that liver is Haida. Do they think that's the chink in the armor of the champion? Jumping knee, left hook to uppercut from Regian Eersel. Haida looking through the brow, catches that kick on the forearm. Good high check there from Haida. Takes the inside leg kick. Rip kick from Haida. We telegraph that left hand in Mustapha Haida. Little quarter turn back to center circle into the flag, his birth country. And an outside leg kick to the back leg there from Eersel to start. Jab two, high kick from Haida. Keep an eye on the lead foot of Eersel to go on the outside of the lead foot of Haida. And for Eersel to throw the right hand when it does. There's the right, there's the flying knee. Haida ties him up, a tango back against the fence. Good refereeing there from Justin Brown. Right hand is a lead punch again from Eersel, then the inside thigh. You just get the feeling that mercury is starting to rise on the champion, Regian Eersel.
I'm telling you, it's that boiling pot of water. He's starting to bubble, man. He's going to try to cook you. He keeps that pressure coming until you're done.
16 match winning streak for Regian Eersel. One of the highest winning percentages in all the kickboxing world. The high kick, the right hand, backs up Haida. Jumping knee! And Haida forced to look sloppy at the moment. Takes in a big breath as Mustapha Haida gets driven back. Another high knee! Regian Eersel has powered up the aggressive meter here in the second round.
You know, when you watch Haida's style, normally he waits for his opponent to break off, and that's where he lands those really nice strikes. Regian Eersel just never steps backwards. Even when the referee here breaks him, he's immediately walking forward and just walking his opponent down.
Haida is unable to establish any sort of tempo, any sort of rhythm. Goes to the body again as he was hunting during the first round, and you see Eersel backs him up once more. When you're on the inside, the high knees come under play.
You can see Haida took a big breath. You know, he just doesn't get that space. Because you know when you're hit, you take that second just to regroup. He doesn't give you that second. He just keeps them coming. That pressure just never stops.
That big breath isn't just about his cardio. It's about him mentally starting to break if this continues.
This is a big, loping, light heavyweight. I mean, a lightweight, 189 centimeters of Regian Eersel coming at you from all angles. And Haida's best weapon so far has been the body shot. The left hand to the body of Regian, tucking it under the elbow, but it hasn't really done the damage that Haida had hoped for.
But look at the stance. Regian's kind of covered up a little bit tighter. His elbows are closer to his ribs, and it's a lot harder to get through that guard now. See the way he deflects?
My knee again. Usually, Mustapha Haida uses a wider stance to really sit into his punches, but he can't do that against Regian Eersel. This is just dominance from the champion. Sticks the right hand in the schnoz again. There's a knee. Constantly backing up Haida. This has definitely been the champion's round. There's no doubt about that. First round may have been a drawn round. Two-punch combo off the bow, roundhouse kick from Haida, just pulled away from the head kick of Eersel.
This is what Haida needs to do. He needs to go low body.
Low.
This side.
Wow, it's been a low knee.
Low was a to the body.
I think I heard cup on that. I heard cup.
We'll have a replay in a moment. It was a strong knee. There's no doubt about that. We could have hit exactly that.
Well, referee's called an injury timeout, so he has a duration of the round to recover from this.
Take us through this, Rich.
He's just right here, and then he goes to throw a jumping knee. And,
oh yeah.
Was that body?
That's not body.
Okay, just want to make sure.
That's not body. Oh, yeah. You may need the full recovery time at 3 minutes allowed, or the duration of a round.
Respect the height of those. Oh, shook it off. Ready to go.
Out. Wow, Mustapha. Back into it. Oh.
Up.
Nope.
Up. Let's go.
Wow, that was dangerous. Eersel is just oozing with confidence out of every pore here, the champion.
Yeah, just to clarify for the audience there, he was not trying to kick him. Mustapha actually slipped while Eersel was throwing a leg kick, and that just almost clipped him when he was down.
Now, if it had clipped him on the way down, that would have been perfectly legal, Rich.
Absolutely.
Jab to cross there from Haida. Nice weave under him, body shot from Mustapha Haida.
I think that one stung him a little bit there. That stung him.
That was the best move of the night so far from Mustapha Haida. Doesn't give him confidence. Eats an uppercut off the right hand. Eersel immediately powers back, chin through the top of the head, body head from the champion, lunging right hand from Eersel. High kick. Oliver did stun the champ. He's not showing it. He's powered right back on top again. On the inside. Thought about pulling the head down for the knee. Body shot. How do you stop an absolute terminator like Regian Eersel? Looking for win number 17 in a row. Probing jabs, trying to measure for the cross hider. He cannot get the distancing. Again, you see that Eersel just drifted away. Got to get inside that jabbing range of Eersel. Side now, and the referee breaks them. Under a minute remaining, 3-5.
I think that early combination landed by Haida kind of disrupted the rhythm of Regian Eersel. He's kind of taking his foot off the gas and not really applying that same sort of pressure. Haida needs to capitalize on this break in the action, start putting it on Eersel.
You know, earlier there, Haida slipped into the inside of Regian's combinations. And if I was his corner, I might tell him to play around with that on the inside, do a little dirty boxing and whatnot, instead of standing at range like this and trying to move around and outmaneuver these punches.
20 seconds to go. Another groin strike there.
Official penalty, and it'll result in not only a 10% deduction of Regian Eersel.
10 seconds.
Purse, but it can also affect the scorecard as well.
Champ two from Haida. Some better signs from Mustapha Haida in that round, and from a hurting shot like that. penultimate round here. 30-28 on my scorecard after three to Regian Eersel. It's unofficial, of course. Outside leg kick from the champion. 7 centimeters taller than the challenger. Beautiful sweep out of that support leg there. Nicely placed from Eersel. And again, you see what I was talking about earlier on during his walkout, how there's such efficiency in the striking of Eersel. He's not a windmill. He doesn't just flurry wildly hoping something will land. He finds an opening, he chooses it, and he hones it, laser guided.
I like the traps that Regian Eersel starts to set. He throws something real soft and loose, sees what your reaction is, and then he throws something back with just a little bit of a feint, but then he lands something successively. It's really impressive to watch him do work.
Our main event of ONE Championship, Fists of Fury 3 from the Singapore Indoor Stadium. What a night of action it's been. This is truly an entertaining main event. Regian Eersel in control. Haida far from done though. Jumping knee from the champ. Haida falls back again. Another jumping knee to the jaw.
Jumping knees like jabs.
He does. Coming in left and right. It's an aerial assault from the man from Suriname.
See, I think that little break that Eersel took in the third round just invigorated him for the next 4 and 5, because he knew going into this one that Haida was going to be hard to get out of there, and he was planning on 5 hard rounds.
Oh, the high kick hurt him. The body shots the uppercut from Regian Eersel, and Haida somehow still standing. Regian Eersel finding his flow again here in the fourth round.
Turn around. Let's go.
Look at gasping for air, Haida. Gasping for air now. It's an all-out assault and battery here from Regian Eersel. Another jumping knee.
These types of combinations and these swarming all over his opponents have gotten a lot of his opponents out of there. But Haida is still in it. Still
for
keeping
that
warrior spirit.
Yeah, for that reason, you can never write off Mustapha Haida, because we know one power-laden punch could turn the tide.
He just needs to get a little bit of confidence back. He needs to land a big left hand, get some confidence, and then earn some respect and slow down this forward pressure coming from Regian Eersel.
Front kick there from Haida. Eersel continually coming forward, trying to back up Haida. Rib kick, overhand power shot there from Haida. Can't rely on the single strikes though.
Actually have a stat on the number of jumping knees per second that Regian Eersel throws by chance.
No, but he is, according to our stats team, they've just told us he is the fastest athlete in all of ONE with the highest average strikes thrown per bout. That is across all styles. His average, 234 strikes, our stats team tells us. That's phenomenal. Roundhouse kick there from Regian Eersel. Lots of instructions from the champion's corner. Good poking right hand, and again, look at the punching combinations now from Eersel. Mustapha's in no man's land, body, head, uppercut, rattling off the combinations. Right hand lead again.
Go home! Break the back!
Justin Brown telling Haida to keep working. Haida would just love to take a few lungs full of air. Eersel answers back. Good leg kick. Steps off the center line. Cracks down on it. That 45 degree trajectory. You want to use for a leg kick. You never want to go straight across. You want to chop down. Scooping body shot, front kick kicks the balls and feet in the midsection. Uppercut misses from the champion. High check there from Regian. Knee to the shoulder, they tie up. Okay, Mitch, play coach, 80 seconds to go. What are you screaming to Mustapha Haida?
He's got to go. He's got to put the pedal down and put it all on him. He's got to go forward, right? Because you can see Rahan's clashing forward. He's got to start letting go of that right, that left hand.
There's been a couple moments in this round where Haida's just done a little bit of work on the inside, and you can see where he comes under and he clinches when the referee breaks him. That's where he's making his really big mistake here, because every time the referee breaks him, he breaks him at distance. He needs to get that work done on the inside.
45 seconds remaining now for Mustapha Haida to find a knockout on Regian Eersel. It's been Eersel in control from the second round onwards. A very close opening round, may have gone either way.
But it's hard to get your, put your chin down, tuck your head, and smash into an oncoming train, Rich. You're going to try to get the way out of it. You don't want to stand there and take it.
I understand, but if you keep doing the same things, it's going to produce the same results. So you got to do something different.
Eersel hunting for a knockout. Final 10 seconds. It looks like we're going down to the judges in our main event. That one staggers him. Right hand just before the bell from Regian Eersel. I may change his first name from Regian to Wrecking.
Regian Eersel.
The Reign of Gold.